Hi, I'm George Marriner Maull, Artistic Director of the Discovery Orchestra, and welcome to Notes from Under the Piano, stories from my life as a musician, conductor, and teacher. It all began when, as a child, I liked to recline under our grand piano as my mother practiced, and the rest, as they say. Lead sponsors for Notes from Under the Piano are Judy Musicant and Hugh Clark, and the Kozlowski Family Foundation. Major sponsors are David and Ellen Williams. Today's episode, Outdoor Concerts. Everyone loves outdoor concerts. Well, almost everyone. I thought it might be good to share a performer's perspective on these much-enjoyed events. First of all, are we talking about a daytime or an evening performance? Both have their potential hazards for the participants. If an orchestra is playing in the middle of the day or even late afternoon, think for a moment about how hot it might be on the stage where the sun is baking down. When temperatures are up there and the musician's hands and fingers are perspiring, the fingerboard of a violin or cello becomes a very slippery place. Slippery is not conducive to the best playing, not to mention the effect all of this moisture and heat has on the strings themselves. Just keeping your violin in tune at an outdoor concert can become a monumental chore. Then imagine what actually happens to the sound of a cello when it's played outside. While percussion and brass instruments have functioned quite well outdoors for thousands of years, picture a Roman legion marching in your direction. Strings were never intended to be played outside. They need the four walls and ceiling of a vibrant room or hall in which to reverberate. If you have a stringed instrument, go out on your deck or porch and notice how, as you play, the sound evaporates into thin air. Now, let's switch to the evening concert. How would you like to be buzzed by gnats and mosquitoes as you attempt to play your clarinet? While I was an undergraduate in music school, I spent several summers as a cast member in an outdoor musical called The Stephen Foster Story, produced in Bardstown, Kentucky. As you can imagine, there was a lot of singing to be done in The Stephen Foster Story. In unbearably hot, sweaty 19th century costumes, and I can remember on more than one occasion as I took a deep breath to sing the next line of music, I inhaled a few gnats along with the air. Fun. The worst incident occurred when I realized that an enormous beetle was crawling up my trouser leg, and knowing that I could not exit the stage to remove it before doing a 5-minute romantic scene with another cast member. I'll spare you any more details about that episode. Perhaps the most distressing aspect of outdoor concerts from the point of view of the Discovery Orchestra is that we know the audience members may not be actually listening to the music. They might be focused on their picnic, talking with their friends, or even taking a nap. All of these activities may occur at just the moment when a composer has some really important musical information to share with us. But that magical musical moment might occur just as your taste buds are being flooded with the sensory delight of your sandwich. Oops, you missed it. The next time you attend an outdoor concert, you'll be aware of all the extra drama going on behind the scenes, as well as the opportunity to put down your sandwich and listen better.